Hey, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video with an image of another famous spot from the Bächers Garten area. And for this image, I hope I can restore some nice detail from the darker areas and also apply a nice cold style on this photo. I guess I will be mostly using Lightroom, but maybe also a little bit of Photoshop later. But before I go on, let's first check out the before and after images. Okay, and then let's start in the lens correction tab by activating those two settings to remove chromatic aberration and enable the profile corrections. And let's go back to the top, and right away for the profile I want to choose Adobe Landscape. This will simply boost the base saturation of the image a little bit and also help restoring some detail from the darker areas since it makes those areas a bit brighter. And for the white balance, I'm going with the daylight settings, since this will help apply this cold color style already without making the colors look too unreal. Right, now the image is rather dark, so let's fix that by simply increasing the exposure. And since this will make the clouds in the back a little bit overexposed, let's drop the highlights to fix that. Also, I want to increase the shadows to get back some detail from the darker areas. And now when looking at the histogram, we do have some room on the right side. That means I can increase the whites without overexposing and make this image even brighter. Alright, now as you can see, the image starts to get really saturated. So let's drop the vibrance. And then I already want to add some clarity. Okay, and then start with the local adjustments. Now let's go to the gradiated filters first. As you can see, I have applied three of those. Let's start in the foreground. Now in the foreground I want to have a lot of structure, and that's easily done. First I'm going to increase the clarity all the way up. Maybe not all the way up, but I want to raise it quite a lot. Then I also want to add some texture. Drop the highlights a little bit. And maybe even add some contrast. Then let's go to the gradiated filter on the left side. I want to use this to brighten up this area since this is kind of dark here. So I'm simply increasing the exposure again. Oh, then we have this gradiated filter left. And here I'm doing the opposite. I'm decreasing the exposure to have a nice dark sky. Oh. Okay, that's it for the gradiated filters. Then let's head over to the radial filters. And here I only have applied two. Let's start with this one, which is basically covering the whole building in the center of the image. And I simply want to add some more clarity into this area. Okay, and then we have this one left. I want to add some kind of subtle glow to this area, so I'm increasing the blacks. And I also want to increase the whites. Okay, now that's it for the local adjustments, then let's go do some color grading. Now first off, I really don't like those green color tones, so let's change the hue of the green tones. Let's drop it all the way, which will give those green tones a nice warm color tone. I guess I could also drop the yellow ones a little bit. Alright, and then let's play around in the saturation tab for a moment. I want to get rid of the aqua tones. That doesn't make a big difference, but it's there way in the back of the image. And let's maybe drop the green ones as well. Then let's maybe increase the orange tones. And I think that looks good this way. So now we have a nice reduced color palette. That means we have some blue tones up in the sky against some warm orange tones in the foreground, and this should work pretty good. Then let's also do some split toning, but I'm not touching the highlights. I simply want to apply a cold color tone to the shadows. And I think something like this will look good. And then of course, let's do some sharpening. And that's it for the Lightroom part. Now I'm switching over to Photoshop to do some final fixing. And of course, let's first get rid of the vignetting. So I'm simply using the spot healing brush, zoom in a little bit, and then fix that by brushing over it. Okay, and let's see, maybe I'm removing some things from the foreground. Then let's see if we can find something nice from the Nik collection to apply. And in this case, I think I'm just going with the classical soft focus and mainly focus on the sky for this effect. Let's switch the method because I think the first one is maybe a bit too bright. So I want to go with the second one. All right. And since I only want to have this effect in the sky area in the back, I'm going to apply a layer mask on this layer. Then I hit Ctrl I, which fills it with black. And then I'm grabbing the brush tool by pressing B. And with the foreground color set to white, I'm brushing over the sky. Then let's merge those two layers. And maybe do a little bit of dodging and burning. So let's create a new layer and switch its blending mode to overlay. Then again, grab the brush tool and maybe drop the brush opacity to around 10%. Now with the white brush, I'm making a few spots brighter. Then let's grab a dark black brush and make a few spots darker. Alright, and that's pretty much it for editing this shot of the Obersee in the Berchtesgaden area in southern Germany. So I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions regarding the editing, then please let me know in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.